Hello and welcome to the Power BI March 2021 update. In this video, we'll explore what's new this month and see some demos of the highlights. We have some exciting new updates for you in the reporting section. First, for the direct query for Power BI datasets and Azure Analysis Services preview feature, we've added some more capabilities that will be synced between a remote source and the local model that you create in Power BI Desktop. Now, display folders and sort by column properties set in a remote source will be synced with your local model. Next, in the Azure Maps visual, we're releasing new selection features that make it even easier to explore location data in Power BI. You'll find them grouped together in a new selection control option available in the toolbar on the top right of the Azure Map visual. You can use the radial and box selection tools to create, circle or rectangle selection areas on the map canvas, the polygon selection tool to draw a freeform selection area on the map, or the range selection tool to select all data within a specified driving distance or a driving time from a particular point on the map. The selection control tools are enabled by default. To turn them on or off, you can use the selection control toggle in the map settings card in the formatting pane. Next, continuing our work on the small multiples preview feature, we've added word wrap to small multiple titles. Now you can ensure your longer titles aren't truncated if they run beyond the width of the small multiple column. Keep in mind that we will allocate space for the longest category name in all of your small multiples to ensure the plot areas align properly. As a result, if some of your small multiple titles are much longer than others, turning on word wrap may leave extra white space under the shorter titles. We encourage you to consider the trade-off between the space reserved for plot areas and also titles when considering word wrap. In the analytics section, we now support adding vertical reference lines for line charts with continuous x-axes. You can create this line by selecting Add in the x-axis constant line card in the analytics pane. And you can configure its color, transparency, style, layer position, and data label just as you can with horizontal reference lines. This constant line is also used in anomaly detection to indicate the location of anomalies in your data. In the modeling section, we have a few new updates to the preview of the new Model View UI. We've added an indicator to make it easy to identify limited relationships between different source groups. These relationships have special behavior, which you can learn about in our documentation in the video description below. We've also added tooltips to error icons. When you're in live connect mode, errors on measures will display an error icon in the fields list and in the model diagram. When you hover over the icon, a tooltip will display more information about the error on that measure. Next, we are introducing a new DAX function, IF.EAGER. This function has the same behavior as the existing IF function, but performance may differ between the two due to differences in how functions are executed by the engine. With IF.EAGER, the two branch expressions are evaluated regardless of the condition being true or false, whereas with IF, only one of the branch expressions is evaluated. Next, we've added extra flexibility in specifying multiple filters when working with the CALCULATE function. For example, previously we would need to add an explicit table filter when searching rows that match one of the two conditions across two different columns. Now you can use OR with those filters together without any errors. This makes it easier to build calculations that require multiple filters and complex combinations of conditions such as AND and OR. In the data connectivity section, we have made it easier to publish Power BI reports to the service that connect to Denodo using DirectQuery, leveraging Kerberos-based single sign-on via the on-premises data gateway. We're also releasing updates to the Exasol, Automation Anywhere, Zoho Creator, eWay, eWay CRM, Intelligent Planet, Data Virtuality, Vena, FactSet, and MariaDB connectors. We have some exciting new updates for you in the service section. First, featured content on your homepage now includes metadata as to who featured the artifact. Further, endorsed content can also now be featured in the same workflow. To learn more about these updates, check out the link in the video description below. Next, you can now open the dataset details page from the workspace content list view. When clicking on a dataset in the workspace content list view, opening this page will provide you with meaningful information and quick actions, including information about the dataset, like the last refresh time, a list of reports built on top of the dataset, usage metrics for the last 30 days, the ability to view lineage, create a report, or analyze in Excel, and the ability to create a new report from template. Please note that this feature is only available in the new workspaces, not Classic. And lastly for this month, you can now filter the apps gallery to view only certified and promoted apps. These apps were set by their owners as trusted. In the visualization sections, we have some exciting new and updated visuals for you. New this month is the multi-card KPIs visual by TMEAG. Updated this month are the Smart KPI List by Nova Silva, the Comparison Chart by Mogula, and the Combo Bar Pro visual by Zoom Charts. More information on all of these new and updated visuals can be found on our blog. This month's editor's picks are the Ratings visual by Mac Software, the Comic Gen visual by Gramina, and the Smart KPI List by Nova Silva. You can find these editor's picks and all of the other mentioned visuals on AppSource. We have two new template apps for you in the template app section. Template apps allow you to save time by connecting your own data to a pre-built report that you can personalize and share. But first, we're excited to announce that template app publishers can now allow Power BI Pro users to download a PBIX file directly from your template app once they've installed it. All you have to do is turn on the Download PBIX feature in the Control tab when you're creating your template app. With this change, template apps are now a one-stop shop for distributing Power BI datasets, reports, and dashboards outside your organization. The first new template app this month is the Analyze Popular Stocks with Power BI. This app shows you multiple KPIs to start your analytics journey in Power BI. You can use it to track end-of-day quotes as well as weekly, monthly, or yearly trends for popular stocks and ETFs. See Power BI in action by tracking stock highs and lows, moving averages, sector-wide distribution, Bollinger Bands, and even performance comparisons for popular stocks over time. This app is brought to you by the Power BI team and is available on AppSource now. And we've made sure that the app can pull refreshed end-of-day stock data without any additional subscriptions. Keep in mind that getting this stock data requires a Power BI Pro license. And if you don't have Power BI Pro, go ahead, give it a try with a free trial today. The other new template app is the Facebook Ads Overview Report by Windsor.ai. This template app helps advertisers and marketers connect Power BI to the Facebook Ads Insights API. The app contains a connector, so to get started, all you need is access to a Facebook Ads account. As with other templates, this app offers automatic data refresh and you can set a date range to get historical data. You'll see two visually rich report pages full of insights about campaigns and ad sets, and a variety of breakdowns including by country, age, gender, and more. If you're interested in trying out either of these new template apps, please check out the links in the video description below. We have a few new updates for you in the Embedded section. First is the new Power BI Embedded Analytics Playground. This allows developers to get hands-on coding experience in our developer sandbox using their samples or their own reports. Developers can discover and interact with client APIs and see instant results. Additionally, you can check out our interactive feature showcases to get inspiration on how to apply the latest features to your applications. Next, the preview for the second generation of Power BI Embedded became available recently for Azure subscribers to use during the preview period. Embedded Gen 2 offers enhanced performance, greater scale, lower barrier to entry for paginated report and AI workloads, instant scaling with no downtime, and improved metrics that allow developers to auto-scale up and down with scripts or Azure Alerts rules. To learn more about this preview, check out the link in the video description below. We've also made a new Contoso sales demo available for Power BI Embedded Analytics, allowing you to explore a data-driven application with customized dashboard views built on Power BI Embedded Analytics. Learn how a Microsoft Dataverse database with row-level security ensures each user only sees the data they have access to, sees APIs in action, including exporting, custom action buttons, and others, and most importantly, browse the open source code behind the demo via GitHub and customize it with your own data. We've also released new client APIs documentation. Inside, you'll find new articles explaining how to use Power BI Embedded Analytics client APIs and how to get started with embedding Power BI artifacts. And we've included references for all our client libraries, Power BI Client, Power BI Models, and Power BI Report Authoring. We have a few final updates for you this month. First, if you're a Windows 7 user, please note that the Power BI desktop stopped supporting Windows 7 on January 31st, 2021. New releases of Power BI Desktop are only supported on Windows 8.1 or newer versions of Windows. And lastly, last month we introduced changes to the certificate revocation check to give you more fine-grained control over what is accepted as a valid certificate. This month, we're adding those controls in the Power BI Desktop options. And last but not least, a reminder to bring all of this knowledge together, you can go to community.powerbi.com to connect with your business intelligence experts and peers. The Power BI community is a great place if you're new to Power BI or an expert. And the community is where you can share your ideas, learn, and get help from other community members on anything related to Power BI. So go ahead, join us. Register at community.powerbi.com. And that's all for this month. As always, we hope you enjoy the updates and please keep sending us feedback on what you'd like to see in upcoming releases. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next month.